Yo guys, Hans here, and this is a headphone guitar amp. And why is this thing so important for me? And for you? So let's find out. But first, before we start talking about the guitar headphone amp, this is my current setup. Now this is my guitar amp. It's from Dean Markley, and I have this for like 20 years now, and the amp is really good, and that is plugged on a mixer. Now over here, guys, which I have my effects, my distortion, flanger, and my looper. Now there's nothing wrong with playing on this amp, but the problem is it's way too loud, and I can't play my guitar in different places like in the shower, outside, sounding like a tin can because it's unplugged, right? So the only thing, if you want to play your guitar plug, is you need a large amp so you can hear the sound of your electric guitar. But there's a solution for that. The Ammoon guitar headphone amp. Now, all you have to do is just plug this in on your guitar, get a pair of headphones, and start jamming. And of course, no one can hear you but you. Now, if you're wondering what it sounds like, now I'm going to plug this Ammoon guitar amp on my lapel mic, which is not turned on the first recordings. Now it's actually turned on, so I do apologize for the not so good audio. Now it's plugged in. Now what I'm going to do here is I am going to take off the cover or the dead cat. Now there is a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack here, or a microphone input. Now I have a pass through. Now, I'm not sure what it sounds like on your end because it's the first time that I did that on a lapel microphone. Now, let me just put this, you know, this little cute dead cat. It's not actually a cat. It's just a term, okay? So I actually listened to it on the playback of the recording. Now, I plugged it here on a pass-through cable, which is a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, or a, you know, that thing. Now, it's actually meant to be plugged in on a headphone, not on a pass-through cable through a lapel microphone. So it sounds like, you know, like, you know, some static sounds, because this is transmitting a wireless signal, which interrupts the amp. But when it's plugged on your ears, on a headphone, it doesn't sound like that. Now, this has a built-in overdrive. Okay. Now, the best way that I can do that is just, you know, put the headphones over here and hope that you can hear it. Now, that's the overdrive. Now, if we turn that off and we just go to the clean one. This is the clean one. Now that's the sound of the clean one. So this device is meant to be used by a headphones. Alright guys, so let's talk about what it comes with. First, we have the classic rock Ammoon guitar or headphone guitar amp. Now we also have this cable. This is a pass-through cable to your smartphone, or if you have a backing track, you can use that, or an MP3 player. And now this is a split cable. So what we have here is a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. And if you have a jam person with you, you can plug in another headphone so she or he can listen to what you're playing. And of course, you have this charging cable, which has a very, very old school mini USB port, which is, I don't even know what it's called, but it's not the standard one. And that's what you get in the box. All right, guys, so now let's talk about the classic rock Amron headphone guitar amp. Okay, so we have it on a plastic material, and we have LED lights here. When you turn it on, you have indicators. So right now it should be 4, but I'm using this for like a few days now. So that's the battery level that I have here. Okay, now it has the plug that plugs into your guitar. And on the back side, we have 4 screws. Now, over the top, we have our controls. Now, we had phone for a headphone. Let me get a headphone. Now, this type of headphone works, okay? But sometimes, if you have like a 3-pin here, you need to really plug it in so and try to wiggle it a bit so the headphone actually works. But if you only have like a 2 rings, or as you can see here, I have like 3 rings, right? This also has a microphone built in, right? So this headphone amp doesn't recognize that. It only recognizes the 2 pins, the left and right ear. So you have to play around on the port here to make sure that both ears are working. So that's one thing to note. Now moving on, we have our, oops. All right, now moving on, we have our controls, which is the headphone that I just talked about. And we have the drive. This is the overdrive, which the level of overdrive that you get. Now from lower to higher. And we have the tone, so, and the volume, all right? Now this is the on and off switch, as you can see over here. There you go. Now, I have LED indicators over here. Now this should be 4, but I actually used it. Now it's just 3 bars, okay? This is the actual bars of the headphones, the power. Now over here on the left side, we have an aux in. Now this is where the cable works, okay? Now you plug this in. So if you have a backing track, now for example, you have like garage band turned on your cell phone, or you have a MP3 player on your cell phone, or now you can plug this in. But of course, make sure your phone has a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack or it will not work. Now, if you have a backing track, like for example, I have a few songs here that I made. For example, Smells Like Teen Spirit. You can use that as a drum loop. Now, and you can plug this on your guitar. And of course, you're not gonna hear that because we don't have any speakers. Now we're going to use this one. Plug it on the headphones. Okay, maybe louder the volume. And now this is plugged on the guitar, and then you can play with your backing track. And I'm going to put this on my lapel microphone so you can hear it a bit. Let's do this. So I'm not entirely sure if you heard that, but that is the best way to use this guitar or the headphone guitar amp. Now charging this thing is, we have over the right side, we have a USB charge. It says USB charge. Now you have this and plug it on. Now you can charge this on a power bank, which I have here, that I hope it has battery. Now, as you can see, your a single blinking light, it means it's charging. Now, once the light is no longer there, it means it's fully charged. So that's how simple it is. Now it charged for around 2 hours.
Alright guys, so let me know what you think about the headphone guitar amp from Ammoon. Now what I have here is the Classic Rock. They have different types of amps with different sound signatures from different amps. So I have the Classic Rock, which kind of sounds decent enough for me. Now let me know what you think about this, and of course I'll be linking some links down below in the description box where you can get this product. So if you're interested, you can use that link and it helps me a lot. And of course, consider subscribing. Again guys, my name is Hans and this, and for more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next one, and thanks for watching. Peace out.